Hello, and welcome back to the Banker's Masterclass series sponsored by EY, looking at transformation in banking. I'm Joy Macknight, editor of The Banker, and with me in the studio is Jan Bellens, Global Banking Capital Markets Sector Leader, EY, to discuss top tips for success. Thanks again for joining me, Jan.
Great to be here, Joy. Thanks for having me.
So I know that EY did a lot of research banking transformation leaders, and also came up with six recommendations, top tips for success. Three of them we'll discuss in this chapter, and then three we'll discuss in chapter three. I guess the first recommendation that came to the fore was really about redefining transformation. And so what does that mean to reimagine transformation?
Yes, that redefinition has really to do with the fact that transformation really means radical change. Radical change to products, to services, to business models, and also to the employee and the customer experience. Oftentimes, transformation gets, you know, boxed in and gets assigned to a chief transformation officer and is not an organization-wide change program that is really required. So it's that definition that's important. And interestingly enough, a lot of our questions were to chief transformation officers, and they oftentimes don't like their title and their role, because it looks like the whole burden of transformation falls onto them rather than on the organization as a whole and the broader leadership team.
And then the second tip was really leading from the top. You know, how important is, senior leadership engagement with the transformation program to the success of the project?
It's absolutely critical, Joy, and it's not just leadership from the top, but I think it's really aligned leadership from the top. Again, back to that role of the chief transformation officer, and you know, what's interesting was that the majority, they actually didn't like their title, and not a lot of them actually really enjoyed their role, because oftentimes it was like, oh, you know, I'm responsible for transformation, which was often a bit of a cop-out for other executives to really drive the change in their part of the organization. So it's really crucial to have aligned leadership that's properly incentivized to drive the change throughout the organization, and that doesn't fall just on that chief transformation officer with that title.
And the third recommendation that came out of this research that you did was really around rethinking transformation ideation. What is that? And then also, how important is that to, again, to the success of a transformation project?
Yeah, I think when banks assess their portfolio of initiatives, of transformation initiatives, I think a great suggestion we got from a lot of the chief transformation officers is really to engage with executives and employees in driving and assessing that portfolio. Employees can be a great source of transformation initiatives, and oftentimes that type of crowdsourcing ideas is just not happening. And having a formal process in place to do that can help not only to get great ideas, but also to get organizational alignment about the fact that something really needs to change, because the ideas are coming from the employees and from the front line themselves.
Well, thank you so much for your insights, Jan. In the third chapter of the Banker's Masterclass series, we'll be looking at the three other top tips for success.